Is everybody blowing glass? All the football team, you're all blowing glass, yeah, I guess. So what I'm going to do is explain to you what we're going to do and how we're going to do it. So, I've gathered the glass from the furnace on the end of this iron. I'll bring it back to the bench where I can shape it using some wet newspaper. I'll then put a very small amount of air, just like that, trapping it with my stuff. If I don't do that, it's very difficult to blow the glass. It's like blowing up a balloon. Nothing happens and all of a sudden pop and it goes really big. But with glass, you just put a hole straight through it. So if I put that small bit of air in there, it makes it a lot easier for you to blow. I'll then hold the iron up and ask you to blow nice and gently. Now you have to keep turning, as I've already explained. I'm showing you, if we stop turning, it will fall on the floor. So when you hold the iron, hold it nice and gently between your thumb and your finger. Don't grab it to stop me from turning. Allow me to keep turning the iron through your thumb and your finger. You must create a tight seal with your lips around the end of the iron. If the air comes out the side, the glass will not inflate. Okay? So you have to create a tight seal with your lips. And blow very gently. Just like moving the flame on a candle without blowing it out. It really is that gentle to start with. And then as I nag you saying blow harder, increase pressure slowly. Okay? Don't blow too hard too quick.
Yours, Alice.